If you're selling to the consumer, the end user of a product, and so I want to be clear here, if you're Philco and you're selling that radio to Ford, Ford is not the end user, all right? But if you're Ford and you're selling that car to you, you are the end user, then there's a tax consequence. So everything up to that point is tax exempt. Typically, you give that other vendor your tax ID number, and that runs out of his expenses. It's associated with a tax ID number, and if I'm the tax person, that audit just keeps following those tax ID numbers until I get to the final sale, and that's where the sales tax should occur. Sales taxes, there's many sales taxing jurisdictions. There's the state of Colorado is a taxing jurisdiction. El Paso County is a taxing jurisdiction. The city is a taxing jurisdiction. We have what we call special taxing districts. So maybe you are part of a road piece. I live up in Monument, and they put in the Baptist Road interchange. Well, the federal funds weren't there to put the bridge in yet, but Walmart and Home Depot were going in there, and the existing bridge wasn't going to handle the traffic flow. So they created a bond. That bond was paid for with a 1% sales tax within that special taxing district. So if you buy something at that Walmart, there you're paying 1% that's going back to a bond until such time as the state money comes out of their budget to pay for the renovation of that bridge, which has already been done 5 years ahead of time, but then that pays off the principal of the bond, and then that tax goes away. All right? Now, many of you may be dealing with internet stuff. So here's how that works. There's two parts of that, two parts of taxes. There's a sales tax component and what we call the use tax. So if I were to go, you collect sales tax, the purchaser pays the use tax. So when you buy something online and you pay, it's a tax-free scenario there, it's 100% use tax to you. Technically, you're obligated to pay the sales tax to the state, to the county, to the city, and any special taxing district that you might reside in where that property was delivered. Do you do that? Probably not. But as a business, I'm going to tell you what. That auditor can get some money by looking at you at a business, but as a consumer, it's probably not worth it. I mean, all of us are speeders on the highway, but you know, only a few of us get caught. Kind of the thing. So the end of the day is, the ones who get caught are the guys who run the really flashy cars and are going really fast, and that's the businesses. So they're going to go after the businesses primarily. So it's something that you need to know. So the deal is, you collect the taxes for the jurisdictions that you have in common with where the delivery was. So if anybody has ever taken delivery and had delivery, like I live up in Monument, I don't live in the city of Colorado Springs. That's a 2.5% taxing district that's in there. So when I go ahead and have it delivered and I take ownership there, I pay El Paso County tax and state tax, but I do not pay the 2.5%. Sometimes the delivery cost is less than that 2.5%. I just bought a new flat screen TV, and I think it was the total price of the deal was like $1,600. I had it delivered to my house. The delivery cost was like, I forgot what it was. It was, you know, $50, but my taxes would have been like $75. And so consequently, it was cheaper for me to have it delivered than to take it and pick it up at the store because of that. Now, you have an internet business, and you're selling to somebody in Kansas. What taxing jurisdictions do you have in common with them? Zero. So there's no taxes that you do that, but it's obligated by them to pay those additional taxes.